Hey productizers, in this lesson, we're going to learn how to build client websites without having to code. Not only that, we're going to see just how quickly you can design these sites, which is important because it will give you more time to focus on marketing, sales, and growth. The tool that we're going to use is Offsprout, which is the website building platform that we built to run and scale my web design agency, JurisPage. Offsprout is now available as a white label website builder, and in my admittedly biased opinion, it's the best way to quickly get started building your productized web design agency. So let's jump into the demo now. So now we're on offsprout.com and I'm going to create a demo site through the homepage right here. So I click on the create your demo site button, put my name and email in, click create, and that'll create a demo site that I can play around with. So here's our demo site, and you'll see here it gives you a quick tour, and we'll show you around, but I'm gonna just fast forward through that just because we're doing this demo live. And now you can see the front end editor in Offsprout. So as you hover over different content, it gives you the ability to click and edit that content. You'll notice that right now this header is kind of faded out, and that's because we're in the page view, which allows you to edit content that's specific to that page. But we can also switch to the site-wide view, which allows you to edit content that occurs on multiple pages throughout your site, like your header and your footer, and we'll see your sidebar later on. There's also the live view that you can see your site as a visitor would see your site. So let's go back to the page view and we'll just click this. And maybe we don't do branding, so we'll just make a quick update right there and click update, and you can see making content updates is that easy. And if you want to add a sprout, we call our content blocks sprouts. You just click this plus button here and you hover over wherever you want to add it. You can add new columns just by going to the side like this, or we could put it on top. So we'll add a new sprout on top right now. And we'll say what we do. We'll create that. And here you can see this is probably not the best homepage design, but you can get the idea of how we would go about adding new sprouts and new content. If we want to delete the sprout, which we probably do in this case, we just click this red X and the sprout gets deleted. So the next thing that we should talk about is container sprouts. So these are sections of your website that allow you to put other sprouts inside them. So this red box signifies the borders of a container, and if we want to edit that container, we can just click into it and we'll see here it gives you options for your background image and the background screen, which is kind of a color over the image that makes it easier to read the text. And you can edit your padding and constrain the width to a max width and all sorts of stuff. Make the images grayscale or blurry or increase the brightness, etc. So for this one, I just want to replace some of these background images. And so Offsprout has a lot of stock images built into it, so I'll just pick a couple right here. Those look fine. And I'll delete the one that was there already. And so when you add more than one image, it'll rotate through the images in a background slider. So let's update that and see that live. So here you can see it updated our background image. And as we wait, you can see that it changes the image automatically. And we can go back in, say we want to see the image a little bit more clearly, we can go back in there and we'll go to the screen opacity and we'll bring that down to 40%. Click update, and now you can see the image is much more visible because the screen opacity has been turned down. So another cool thing that you could do with containers is make them sticky. So this is probably going to be our navigation up here. So if we want to make this sticky, we can just check this little sticky switch, update that, and then when we scroll down now, you can see that the navigation already is sticking to the top. So that's all that you have to do to make sticky navigation. So pretty cool. Now let's add a new page. So if we want to do that, we go to the main menu, then we click new, and we could go to a blog page, and we'll add a modern blog, and we'll save our changes. And we'll create that page. And you can see there are no posts to display on this blog, obviously, because this is a brand new site. But if you had posts, it would be there, and you could click in and change how those posts are displayed. There are a bunch of different options for controlling how your blog is displayed. Why don't we just add a blog post right now, actually? So if we go here, my first post. We create that. So here you can see you have your first blog post, and you can see that this particular template has a sidebar, and that's a site-wide section. So if you wanted to edit your sidebar for all blog posts, you would just click into the site-wide view, and you could, you know, create a contact form here if you wanted, and then that would be shown on all of your blog posts. So there's no more widget system, it's just all editing with this one unified front page editor. Also, if we wanted to edit our title tags and other SEO information, we could go into the page meta view, and this gets loaded up with your snippet editor and focus keyword, and so you can optimize your posts for SEO purposes. And many of you will probably recognize Yoast SEO as one of the best SEO plugins, and that's already built into Offsprout. So once you're happy with the site, you can just claim it and create an Offsprout white label account where we'll be able to manage all of our sites from one easy dashboard. So let's do that now by clicking this Create Your Network button. And that brings us to the network dashboard. And so you'll see that you're prompted to set up your account a bit, save your setup process, brand your network, customize your emails. And we can maybe go over that a little bit later, but we're gonna go out of order here and just go straight to the My Sites menu. And you'll see that the site that we were just working on was already added to your account. And you could delete that if you want right here. Or you can go in and edit some high-level stuff. So if you wanted to edit the users that belong to the site, you could do so here. You could activate and deactivate plugins. You could even launch on your own custom domain right here. And then once you're launched, you're able to manage your DNS all from this central dashboard. And right now we're going to create a new site. So you can see there are a bunch of different site templates, and we'll just go with a basic one. Give your site a name. and you can create the site in a new tab. This works best in Chrome, so if you're using Safari or Internet Explorer, this creating in a new tab might not work for you, but you can see it here. So here you have the Offsprout site grower. So this is where you can create all of the pages that you're going to need for your client all at once. And you can even modify this process. So if we click into one of these pages, you can see you're able to choose the design from a list of homepage templates, and you can even make your own templates if you want. We'll just use that default one for now. You can also optionally include some other pages like service pages and contact pages, and we can include multiple service pages, so service one and service two, and let's include that contact page as well. And if we want to modify this and add additional pages, we can go back to our network home and we go to the site grower options, and then we can go down here to the pages step and say we want to be able to add a blog page to all of our new client sites. So we just add page type to site grower and we'll call this blog, and we'll grab page templates from the blog folder. And again, you're able to save your own page templates to whatever folders you want. And we'll give this a default title of blog. And then we'll save that. And then if we go back to our site grower and refresh the page, you'll see we now have the option to include a blog page with all of our new sites. So let's go into that and we'll include, and we'll choose a different design right here. Then the next step is company information. So here you can add some information that is used in site templates and short codes, so that you can enter the company information once and it'll propagate throughout the site. So we'll just add some quick information here. And phone number. And then we'll go configure our initial contact form. So we can change the submit button text there and change who the notification is sent to and from. Then we can add our social media profiles here if we want to. And finally, we'll finish up and it'll grow our new site for us. And so here is your fully designed site. And again, we'll skip the tour since we're doing this demo live. But you can see we have a home page, the two services pages, the blog, and the contact page. And they're all pre-populated by our site grower and fully designed. And from here, we can go in and edit the content, swap out the dummy content for content of our own, or if we figure out that we missed a page, we can go in and add a new page here. And now we can also go back to our My Sites menu, and we can see here that that site has been added to our dashboard. And again, we can manage users, plugins, domain, DNS, all of that from this dashboard. So that, in a nutshell, is Offsprout, and I'll see you in the next lesson where we use Offsprout to build our marketing site. See you there.